Let's see how to perform a combined first trimester screening with SsdwLab 6. We introduce our ID and password to enter to web. It will appear several options and we choose add new patient. The first folder of the screening that appears is patients folder. We notice a series of edit buttons just below the tabs of the folders that allow us to add, edit, delete, save, and cancel. These buttons appear on all folders as we will see. In the patients folder we must enter the data identifying the patient, surname, name, CIP, and date of birth that will let us calculate the age of the patient. In the section called Others, we introduce the race of the patient, which is a correction factor. And in this case the patient is black, we mark the patient as of patient test. The option, patient test, makes that all information relating to this particular patient in screening is considered by all program options as a test or quality control, so that none of your data will intervene in statistical calculations. In the right side of the screen we see a section about contact information of the patient. The following is the pregnancy folder. In this folder we collect information concerning the pregnancy. We introduce the weight of the patient, which is a correction factor. The origin of the ova and the pregnancy type, we leave the default option. And the number of fetuses, in this case is a single fetus pregnancy. The next is the screening folder. We must enter the data screening. That is the date of blood sample extraction. We also introduce the screening profile. We choose a combined first trimester screening profile, which comes by default. We note that there is a section regarding previous anomalies, and another that refers to the correction factors. We can observe the black race is marked. As we have previously defined, the following is blood test folder. We enter the date of the sample, which normally coincides with the date of screening. We will also enter the values of Gaussian biochemical markers that in this screening profile are chorionic gonadotropin beta with its free fraction and pregnancy-associated plasma protein A. The next tab is ultrasound folder. We introduce the date of the ultrasound. Then in biometrics sector we mark use this to calculate gestational age. And we enter the value of the CRL. We can detect how the weeks and days of gestational age are calculated. We also introduce the value of nuchal translucency. And we can observe that MOM of nuchal translucency is calculated automatically. And finally we come to the folder called risk. We find on the top of this folder information about the Gaussian markers used in risk calculations. Thus we see the values of the markers, and their respective MOMs. In the middle left we observed correction factors, and in the middle right we see the estimated risks, maternal age risk, trisomy 21 risk, and trisomy 18/13 risk. These are represented by colored bars, green when the risk is low, red when the risk is high, and the risk of maternal age is always displayed in yellow. In the bottom left of the screen there is information relating to gestational age estimation. In the bottom center there is a box that lets you enter details that will appear in the report. And in the bottom right there is a section that, after completing the relevant tests, we may introduce the diagnostic values, both trisomy 21, trisomy 18/13. On the left side of the screen there is an informative summary of the patient's screening, where appear the screening date, the center, the screening profile, the gestational age, the risks, the MOMs of Gaussian markers, the correction factors and dichotomous markers. If they have been used, we can observe the presence of two buttons. One is the validate button for validating the screening, and the other is the report button. If we click the report button, a report in PDF format is generated in a new tab. What we see is what will be reproduced in the printed report. We can see represented in bars, risk for trisomy 21, and risk for trisomy 18/13. Following these steps were performed a combined first trimester screening.